It's something that most people don't think about when they go to a show, lighting and sound in particular.
No one notices the bad stuff. If you do good light design, no one's going to notice it.
But when you see it on stage, with our cue playing, it really helps us believe we're in a park. It really makes the world play real.
Sam Kuznets is the production manager for performing arts at Bucks Rock Camp.
My job is to look after the schedule and budget and communication between theater, dance, music, clown, video, and the technical theater department's LSD, set, and costume.
Jeff Greenberg is the LSD head of shop.
It's lighting and sound design, which means for any performance, whether it's theater, straight plays, musicals, or dance, we design lighting and we design sound. You know, which is really two different things combined into one department. I really only do lighting myself. We consider Emery to be head of sound. This year we have 7 lighting staff and 2 sound staff. We have some people in the shop who started at Bucks Rock. They started doing lighting here.
With the exception of Jeff, all of our lighting designers were campers here. And our lead sound designer, Emery, was a camper here. Mm-hmm. And I was a camper here. So most of LSD is homegrown.
This homegrown staff doesn't have it easy. They work some of the most interesting hours in camp.
If it's a good day, wake up at noon, start working around rest hour, work throughout the entire afternoon in the nice heat we got here. If we're in the summer theater, 8:30, start focusing lights. If we're not focusing, we're usually in a tech, dress, or a show.
We'll work until 2 a.m. regularly, until 4 a.m. often, and until 8 a.m. twice a summer.
You know, people perceive us as the shop that works overnight, which is true to some extent. We do also work in the daytime. One of our theaters is outdoors. We can't do lighting in the daytime. You know, you turn on a light in the daytime, you can't see it. So we have to wait for darkness to light shows at the summer theater.
They work crazy, crazy hours. So they're often here, you know, from 8 p.m. till they have to quit because the sun comes up.
Tamara Carroll, a theater director, works with designers to create the lighting and sound aspects of her shows.
Of course, actors are a big part of it, but you have to figure out what the setting is like, how that storytelling is going to be supported through creating the world through sound and lights.
What we do as designers is we create the environment that allows the director to see their vision. We determine how every moment of the show is going to be perceived.
Crafting the technical aspect of each show requires thorough and precise design.
We treat each show as a complete ground-up rebuild. So we assume nothing, we decide where speakers will go, and we run cable to them. We decide how many speakers are needed, we decide where the tech table is, which is where we operate sound from. So that all sort of happens anew for each show. Then when we're loading in a show, it's a lot of equipment, it's a lot of cable, runs from here to there, plug this end into that, this is what kind of cable we use for this purpose, this is what kind of cable we use for that purpose.
But aside from the physical work of loading and running a show, campers weren't always participants in the design aspect of LSD.
When I got here as a camper in 94, LSD was sort of like just a satellite of the scene shop.
It was perceived as an activity that campers could run the light board for a show, but there wasn't really much opportunity for campers to be creative. So we started allowing campers to assist us on the shows.
Campers we bring in sometimes as design assistants, where they'll assist like me working on the musical. We'll talk about lights and how we want the show to look with them, and then they'll come with me to the board and we'll start writing cues on the board together, and we'll look at what the stage is like. I'll teach them how to use the board. And then for the tech, dress, and show, they'll be operating the board, taking cues from the stage manager.
If I'm working hands-on, it's usually with the sound department because we have fewer sound staff than lighting staff. Mm-hmm. And my style of work with campers is just side-by-side. Here's what I'm doing, so come help me do it.
For many, the idea of controlling the lighting and sound for a show is greatly satisfying.
For staff on stage, we set up a bunch of cool, flashy lights, and then kids can work the board and, you know, turn lights on and off, choose what looks, and that's very sort of instant gratification.
However, the most rewarding work happens over long periods of time, by staying with a show from beginning to end.
It takes days and days for your work to show its results. I find it very rewarding as they discover how their piece of the puzzle fits in.